To give all praises to God for allowing me to exit the ring safely and for allowing me to be here fighting at the highest level in boxing. I'm all open for questions, man. Anything. I want to thank my team. I want to thank my wife. I want to thank Teddy. I want to thank Teddy for the great tremendous camp. We came up short. Thank you for the clap. Appreciate that. Came up short tonight. Daddy back out was strong, he was solid. He somehow knew what I was gonna be doing, where I was gonna be at. Him and Freddie Roach came up with a great game plan. And I got defeated, man. He was strong, man. Fast and strong. But questions?
Yeah, I'm ready for you. I just wonder, you know, in your first fight, the one that you won, there was 1,500 total punches thrown. Manny himself threw 751, you were 800 something. Tonight, the combined total was 741. What happened in the ring that made the punch total go so much lower than it had been the first time? It was a third of the total.
Well, Manny was luring me in. That's what he was doing. He was waiting on me to commit to lunge in so he could counter me. And then in spots, he would attack me in spots. But he was waiting on me. You know, he was being the ocean tonight.
So, in your opinion, now that you reflect back on it, what should you have been doing? Make him come to you? Would that have been the thing instead of?
Yeah, I mean, I did everything I can to try to get him to come to me. I would jab, get out. But he was just super smart tonight. He was a smarter man tonight, and you know that was it. He was just super smart. He knew where I was gonna be at. He was making me the log.
And I just wanted to ask you, after you have been in 36 rounds with him, you fought a lot of great fighters in your career. Can you put him into context, you know, how good he is and, you know, where you think in recent boxing history with yourself and Mayweather and Marquez and all those guys, where this guy ranks?
Well, I mean, he's the best fighter that I've ever faced, honestly. He's explosive. He has a lot of experience. He has a lot of power, a lot of speed. He's the best battle fighter I've ever faced in the ring. Yeah.
Timothy, Tim, over here to your left a little bit. Tim, I have just a couple of questions for you. Tim, you said afterward that you didn't do good enough for Tim Bradley. Can you tell us what you meant by that?
That I didn't do good enough?
Yeah, you said for Tim Bradley.
Well, I fought the best I could tonight. I don't know. I didn't know what was going on. I wasn't sure. I wasn't tired, but it just seemed like Manny was always in the right spot. He was always in the right spot. He was always looking to counter me. You know, I was trying to get my jab working, getting around him, but he was just smarter. He was just smarter than I was tonight, honestly. He was a step ahead of me. I was supposed to be a step ahead of him. So I couldn't really, every now and then I'll find a rhythm, but then I lose my concentration at the end of the round, and he would try to come on and still around. But he was just always on top of me, man. He was always just a step ahead of me, and I was supposed to be a step ahead of him tonight.
Based on what you saw tonight, do you think Manny Pacquiao should retire?
No. No, okay. Manny Pacquiao shouldn't retire.
Hey, Tim,
how
Timmy.
Hey, thank you, guys. My spirit is not crushed, man. You went from the U.S., and it's all good. I'm good. I'm happy.
You said several times that Manny was smarter tonight. Was he better tonight than he had been in the first two fights against you?
Yeah, he was very patient. He was very patient, and he was just waiting. Like I told you, he was just waiting on me. He was waiting on me to make mistakes. My trainer kept telling me stop lunging, but I felt like I wasn't able to hit him. I wasn't able to get to him. No, he would commit his spots, but he would get out quickly. You know, what I was trying to do is I was trying to lure him in and then get out and then fire back at him. But, you know, when he made a mistake, he corrected really fast, and I couldn't jump on top of him. I was a step behind.
So in spite of the fact that you had 24 rounds with him and thought you knew him, he did things that you didn't expect tonight?
Yeah, he just used distance, and, you know, he just anticipated on me coming in.
Tim, actually, this is for Teddy. Teddy?
over here. There was a lot of talk with Tim during the week about in the previous fights with Manny, didn't really have a game plan. He said he really had a good game plan for this fight. Did Tim follow the game plan tonight? And if so, what was it?
Yeah, listen, I came up short. I didn't serve my fighter enough. I don't think he came up short.
Coach, you didn't come up short, man. Come on.
But I think we had a proper game plan. Give credit to Manny. Manny was terrific. I give him all the credit in the world. But you know, we wanted to take a little bit more advantage of sometimes his preliminary movement before he exploded forward. And there was, I thought, some opportunities to do that, but I don't know that I pushed the right buttons to get that done.
Hey, Teddy, right here. Will this relationship continue? Do you see that happening?
I think Timothy Bradley is the best human being that I've ever been around training. So.
Tim, what was that? Would you like it to continue?
You know, I'm gonna take some time off. I'm gonna enjoy my family. Been away from them for 2 months. I'm gonna go enjoy my beach house in San Diego and relax, kick my feet up, and think about what's next. That's what we're gonna do. I would love for our relationship to continue, but I think we need to let this marinate. You know, think about it. You know, he's away from his family for 8 weeks, away from his wife, his children, his kids, 8 weeks. It's a long time, man. And at this moment, I don't know. We don't know right now. You know, we really can't make a decision, you know, right away. But we'll talk about it, regroup, and think and see what's next for us. Thank you.
Any other questions?
I love you too. Thank you.
Timmy put up a good fight. You have nothing to be ashamed of.
Thank you.
My question is, do you think that you could have brought him a lot closer at certain times throughout the fight? Seems like you were sort of hesitant to get close to throw the power punches that you wanted to throw.
Yeah, well, the game plan was good. Four things I was supposed to do. All right, I was supposed to slip the left hand and come on my hooks. I was supposed to, you know, pull him out on the laundry line, you know, or force him in and then counter punch. You know, feint him, go around to the side. It was a lot of stuff that I wasn't doing. I wasn't listening. I wasn't doing during the fight like I was supposed to do. But yeah, at times when I did attack, I felt that I was doing some damage, but. You know, Manny Brazilian, man, he just set me up occasionally when I came straight in. My trainer kept telling me stop going straight in. He kept telling me to, you know, fake the aggression and go to the side. But occasionally I could do it, but I couldn't do it all night. It just boils down to concentration and focus all the way through. And I think I did it two minutes a night, and, you know, 1 minute off. Anyways, congratulations to Team Pac Al. That's all the questions you guys have for me. Oh, you got one question? Yes. Oh, got another question.
Hey, Tim. To touch on what you just said, I was going to ask you, there was a couple of rounds where it seemed like you were controlling, like the first two and a half minutes, and then he almost like stoked around you, either the last minute, the last 30 seconds, and you almost had a look on your face, and you're going back to the corner of like, he just stole that from me.
Yeah, just that all boils down to concentration. It's something that Teddy always tells me in training camp. You know, you can't lose your concentration. You need to stay focused all the way through the round. And, you know, I don't know if it's a habit. I don't know what it is. But I just lost concentration, you know, midpoint, 2 minutes. And, you know, he would come on strong towards the end. Just a mistake on my part. Who, me?
Yeah.
Man, I'm not done. I'm not done yet. I'll be back fighting, man. Come on. Hey, I still can fight, man. I still can fight. I got beat by a legend, man. I got beat by a legend, man. So, I mean, I'll be back. You know, this ain't gonna stop me. Absolutely. You got one question? Any other questions? Well, I want to thank everybody for coming out. I want to thank my promoter. I want to thank HBO. I want to thank my team, honestly, all the fans. Thank you so much. I want to thank Teddy. I want to thank my father, my mother, my grandma for coming out. I want to thank everybody for coming out.